So we'll go, we're off. Come on, Fluffy. Is there evidence? Okay, just a pool of blood. That's all the evidence you get. Okay. Should we see what this side quest is? You know what? Yeah. Why not?
Have you seen my Chloe? I let her out of her pen while I did my chores. But she hasn't come back yet. I think she's lost. Please, can you help me look for her?
Aw, I can do that.
I can't promise I'll find her, but I'll try. Describe her to me.
She's beautiful, white hair. She lets me stroke her when I'm sad. She's ever such a good girl. So quiet and kind. And she likes walking in the wheat.
Why are you covered in mud? Fields are big. Why you got dirt all over your face?
She must be starving too.
Oh, don't talk about
it. She hasn't eaten anything since yesterday. It is my job to feed her.
In that case, let's not keep her waiting.
Why are you covered? You're covered. Look at your paws. What are those?
That's a lot of feet to search. With a little luck, someone might have seen her.
Look at them. Look at your paws. Look at your paws. And look at your face. What happened? Oh, it's Aisha's fault. Yeah, Aisha, why you got mud on your face too? Aisha just walks out like, don't talk to me. Don't look at me. Don't talk to me. Freya yells about it like, don't judge me. I was having fun. Give me a second. I think she just wants some attention. What happened? You won't come tell mum? What happened? What happened? Yeah. And what else happened? What happened? Why are you covered in mud? Why are you covered here? Why are you covered in mud? Apparently we're taking a husky break. Yeah, it's very, very important to take a husky break. Did you hear me melting over Torgol and you got jealous? Is that what happened? Oh, I see. Okay. Anything else that you'd like to add? You know, that you could... Wow, wow. No more wow, wow. No wow, wow.
You work these fields.
You go find a toy. Go bring me a toy. We can play.
Branded. And an outsider at that, judging by the lack of manners. How should I help you, eh? You tell me that.
Because a girl from the village asked me to find her pet. Chloe. Have you seen her?
Chloe, is it? Oh, little Lisette's plaything. Last I saw, the filthy creature was sniffing about the windmill. That girl's old enough to know she should tie her pet up when she's finished playing with it.
Oh, calm down, she's a kid.
The windmill.
Off with you now. I won't have Idle branded underfoot.
Okay, so we gotta go to the windmill. I'm trying to pet a husky at the same time. It's difficult. Oh, there.
Chloe.
Are you Chloe?
More brown than white. You're not Chloe, are you, girl?
Nope.
Is that someone napping on the job?
It don't look like that. It looked like a dead body.
I hope they don't mind the interruption.
Hi. Now Aisha's come to
Oh my god.
What was that? What was that? What was that? No, don't bite my chair. No, you can't.
Told you it's a dead body.
The crystal's curse.
Chloe, I was calling you. Didn't you hear me?
What?
Get up now. You've slept long enough. It's time to go home.
That's
Chloe?
Disgusting.
Why did you already turn into a rock? I only made you do a bit of magic.
I don't like this town.
None of the other
I want
Chloe's
to leave this town.
Hair. It could be months before Dad gives me another one. I have to wait until they're too tired to work anymore.
Is that all she was to you? A plaything. Do you really not care that she's dead?
She's not dead. She's a rock.
That? The crystal's curse? That's just how she died. And now she's gone forever. Giving another bearer her name won't change that.
No, don't say that.
It's true. And without that brand, she would have been just another girl. Somebody's daughter. Just like you.
Dad said bearers don't have parents.
They do. Parents that give them away. Families they'll never see again. But you became Chloe's family when you took her in. Remember that. And remember her.
I...
Good! Make that girl cry and frickin' understand. I'm done with these side quests, they're pissing me off. Not that the side quests specifically are annoying or anything, I meant that the stories are making me angry. Making me so damn angry.
If the people of Moor are as intolerant as Isabel says, it's no wonder the Empire never sent my unit here.
Come on, Torval.
Are you Bertrand? The dame sent me.
Sounds about right. Only time I hear from her is when she wants something. Well, go on then. What is it?
One of her courtesans has gone missing. And I need to find her. A soldier who may have information on her whereabouts is rumored to have come here to meet with a trader.
Many traders stop to peddle their wares on their way to the capital, but only one's been seen quarreling with a soldier.
Is he still here?
The trader? Oh, yeah. Stubborn sod stood his ground till the soldier got tired of shouting, from what I hear. If you seek him out, keep your head down. Fact is, folks round here would sooner hang a branded than help him.
Mm-hmm.
That's even with the dame's brooch for protection.
Understood.
Alright. Speak with the traveling trader.
Weren't expecting any new branded until you know.
Hello.
What's this? A branded? Where's your master? Must I call for a constable?
I come to you from Northreach, at the behest of the dame. Perhaps you've heard of her.
Why, of course I have. I am the good lady's servant.
Mm-hmm.
What is it that she requires of me?
Rumor has it you were seen arguing with a soldier some few days ago. A soldier with a scar over his eye.
Yes, that's right. He had a comb which he claimed was an antique. Said he wanted
he
to
stole
trade
her comb, seriously?
One. But although it was an antique, it most certainly was not, as I told him. Nevertheless, he insisted that it was of great value and was quite vehement about my appraisal. I stood firm, however, and for all his bluster, he still purchased a new comb, albeit an inexpensive one.
And do you know where he went after that?
My customers aren't usually in the habit of telling me whither they are bound, but as it happens, this one did. Yonder ruins, strange as it may sound.
Okay.
My thanks.
Not at all. I would do anything for the day. Anything.
That sounds nasty.
Be sure and tell her, won't you, that I was helpful.
Why did you have to put emphasis on the anything? Alright. So this way we're gonna go. Yep. I'm guessing there are.
It smells of death here.
Torgul. Oh my god, Torgul, you scared me.
Wolves. We can't let them get any closer to the village.
Keep your distance, boy. Get him, boy. You know what to do. Get him, boy. Sick of Torgul. Sick of Torgul.
Yeah, beat him up. Nice. Enemies slain. Oh no.
Damn it all. Bodies. A man and a woman.
Oh god, is that Tatian?
Well, the wolves have been busy. But the blood is long dry. So it is you, Tatian.
Thought so.
If that's true, then the body next to hers will be Yannick's. The girl Yannick went off to see every night. You said her name was Tatian.
You. Did you follow me?
Obviously.
Now, why would I do that? Unless you think I'd have good reason to. But no. I was sent to find Yannick. By the looks of things, I have.
We both found who we were searching for.
Nah, he was a jealous sod. Couldn't stand the thought of his woman with someone else. Then one day he sees her with a new comb. Thinks she's got herself a new gallant. Tells the garrison he's gonna find the man and kill him. We know it's all talk, but then he disappears off to Moor for some dealings and doesn't come back.
If you mean this comb, it was a gift from the dame.
If only Yannick had bothered to ask, eh? He might not be rotting on a hill.
I think he meant to ask her something else. He stole the old comb and bought her a new one in the hope they'd wed.
Wed? Where would they have gone? Certainly not back to Northreach with a dame waiting.
And we all know what happens
to deserters. Tell the dame I'm sorry for her loss. When the lads come to collect Yannick's body, I'll see that Tatian is delivered to the Vale.
Is that wise?
Ah, there won't be any covering up this mess. The most we can hope for is that the dame doesn't hold it against us. Speaking of which, I saw her in Moor just now.
Oh,
did
great.
You tell her what happened?
Okay.
Might sound better coming from you.
We better go talk to the dame.
Isabel.
Yeah.
Perhaps the comb will give her something to remember Tatian by.
Yeah. Kind of want to go over and get this item first. Because then I know what it is. Oh, we got fangs. Okay, cool. Let's jump over this. Thank you. We got stuck on that.
If it was a mess.
You are still in one piece, I see. You will be pleased to hear that your companions have arrived. They said they would meet you at a little chapel to the east of here.
Thank you, but you need to have come all this way just to tell me. I was on my way to see you.
You found her then?
Yeah, it's not a good story, Isabel. I'm sorry.
I see. My dear Tatien. It is by no means uncommon for a client to fall for a courtesan. Especially a client who's young and far from home. But rarely do such tales have happy endings.
I found this with Tatien. I believe it was yours.
Thank you for returning it. I shall see that it has a place on her pyre.
That's sad. Oh, I think we leveled. Yeah. Nice. Alright, cool. Level 23. Sweet.
I should go.
Before you do, I have one last gift. A token of my thanks. The veil.
Oh god, what
counts
is it?
Among its patrons several high-ranking officers of the Imperial Army.
Oh.
According to one of the looser-tongued gentlemen, it would appear that the legions are planning to march south.
Thank you for the information.
The same thing.
But did he mention that it was all of the legions? This is no mere skirmish. Were I to guess, I'd say the Emperor planned to abandon the capital. But that couldn't possibly be true now, could it? Take care, Clive.
I will. And thank you again.
We have to go to the chapel.
We weren't expecting any new branded until the new.
Let's go, 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 go. Okay. We got some gil. Nice. Open. Not jump. Open. I wonder if it's a trap or not. No, there's Sid. Hi, Sid.
Any trouble on the way?
None worth mentioning.
Oh, and Jill.
As I was telling Jill, it's worse than I thought. The capital's crawling with soldiers.
And here I am, the deserter come home.
Which is why we'll be taking the back door.
Did she just do baby cry? Oh. I can see you, baby. You come here. Freya, come. You were in your pool playing. I don't want to touch you. You're wet. So we're hiding in the pleasure houses? Okay.
Ahem.
you two? Can't think of a safer place in the Empire than it. Brothel.
Really? Doesn't seem very private.
So then, how do we proceed?
We'll be using the glass gate. Tonight, just after sunset.
Where the shards are loaded for transport. That is one of the most heavily guarded points in all of Sambrek.
But not the most, which is a start. Besides, I know a shortcut straight to the heart.
A shortcut? And how exactly did you come to know about this fatal chink in the Empire's armor?
Let's just say I may have attempted something similar before. And may have ended up running for dear life after being discovered by the Harmon, but that's not important.
Sid, if the Mother Crystals truly are the cause of the Blight...
If? You wound me, Jill.
What I'm trying to say is, if the powers that be know all of this, why do they sit idle and allow it to continue?
In case you haven't noticed, the God-fearing people of this realm and their pious leaders care for but one thing, themselves. And they'll do whatever it takes to hold on to power. The rest of us are just a means to an end. The moment you raise your voice against them, you're decried as an outlaw, clapped in irons and slung in a cell to rot.
An outlaw.
Whoever controls the crystals controls the realm. But our kind can wield magic without them. To our rulers, we must seem the most convenient of tools, and the most dangerous.
Makes sense.
What makes them think they have the right to use us? To leave us to die when our bodies are spent?
Does a nobleman weep for a broken mug? A torn tunic?
No.
Our fate means nothing to them. No, this isn't a battle you can win with words. Believe me, I've tried. Nothing ever gets through. The world is simply not ready to listen. So to hell with talking. If they won't give us a say, we'll decide our fates another way. You can't blame a man for wanting to bring an end to all this, can you?
I can't. But what of all the people you mean to rob of their comforts? Are you happy for them to call you outlaw?
Sid the
outlaw. I don't think Sid cares.
Ah, that'll do me.
You might at least pretend to take this seriously.
Have a little faith, Jill. Even if you don't think much of my choice of digs. That means my deeds will be remembered. I'll gladly play the role of villain. But first, we have a gate to crash. And once we're in, there'll be no turning back. So you best make ready.
Okay.
The world won't save itself.
It's time to go do the thing.